Hey everyone, in this video we're going to be walking through how to solve for a root of a nonlinear equation using the Newton's method in Python. As we went through in a previous video, Newton's method is an open root finding method for nonlinear functions, meaning that we pick an initial x value and then we iteratively solve for our root from that point. I will leave a link to a video on the full theory and procedure for Newton's method in the description down below, but let's go through a quick review of what Newton's method is. Let's say that we have a function that looks like this, and we are trying to find where this nonlinear equation crosses the x-axis. Well, we must first start with an initial guess as to where we think the intersection point might be. So let's say it's here at x. Well, using our function, its derivative, and our initial guess in the following formula, we can work our way iteratively towards the x-intercept. So, we get an x value, find the derivative at that point, which is telling us how quickly the slope is changing at that one specific point, the evaluated function at that point, and then we essentially take a step down from the derivative slope, find our new x value, and continue the process. So, after that quick review, let's talk about creating our Newton's method Python function. We're going to set this up as a Python function, as this will give us some flexibility to use this code again in the future for any function that we want to solve using Newton's method. To define our Newton's method function, we need to type def and then give it a name. So let's just keep it simple here and call it Newton's method. Then we're going to have four parameters, meaning our user will have to give us four arguments to satisfy those four parameters. So we will need four inputs, that is the four arguments, from our user to actually run this function. Let's first ask for the user's function, the func, and the user will input this as a string. Then we need the derivative of the function from the user to find the next step in Newton's method. So let's just call this functDeriv. Then we need our user's initial guess, that is the initial starting point from which we'll begin solving for the root of the function. Then we need to know how many iterations the user wants us to run. The more iterations we have, the longer the program will run for, and the more accurate our answer will be should we have a converging solution. To interpret the two strings, the func and the functDeriv, that our user entered as a usable mathematical function, we need to create two functions that will evaluate our function for a given input, and this can be done like so. This Python eval method here is what we can use to turn our user's entered string function to something that Python can read as a proper mathematical function. So, anytime in our code we put f of x, the number we put into the brackets for x will be evaluated using this Python function here, which in turn will solve our function with the input value. So we can just repeat this function again to interpret the string our user enters for the function's derivative. Now, let's just create our simple for loop, which will be our iterative numerical solver. We save for an intercept in range, and then we will say 1 to n, where n is the number of iterations that our user wanted. So our for loop will loop iteratively from 1 all the way up to n. Now we must enter our Newton's method formula, which we discussed earlier. I am going to just use I for our next iteration variable and x as our current iteration variable. So we type that for our next iterations variable, x value, is going to equal our current iterations x guess minus the function evaluated at the current x value divided by the derivative of the function evaluated at the current x value. Then, to update our current x value, we must say that our current x value is going to equal our next x value, so it takes on its value. And that is really all we need to do to begin solving problems using Newton's method in Python. As an example, let's say that we are told to solve for the two roots of x squared minus 2. As we can only solve for one root at a time, let's begin by solving for our rightmost root. And to do this, we first need to call our function. To call a Python function, we just need to type the name of the function, so Newton's method. Then we need to give it the arguments for this given function. So we'll enter our function of interest as a string, enter the derivative of our function as a string, our initial guess of x, and how many iterations we want this to run for. Then let's just copy and paste this function call and change our initial guess somewhere much lower. If you have a function and you are unsure of a good initial guess, it is always a good idea to first graph the function and then make a guess based on that. Then, when we run our function, we receive the following information. And if we head over to desmos.com and actually graph our function, we can see that we do land on the same roots. So there we go, we have just implemented Newton's method into Python. Although this may not be the most efficient possible way to code Newton's method in Python, I hope that it helped you and maybe taught you something along the way. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of the procedure behind Newton's method and how we implement it into Python. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking the join button below or our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.